Karimir, BBTV. I'm very happy to be joined by Huey Fury. Nice little surprise. Come over here to see your old man, and you was here training. Great surprise. How long have you been back in the gym now?
Back in a while now. Just been staying quiet, keeping myself to myself, and just ticking along.
Yeah, yeah. Now, first thing to notice is when we come in, and your old man was telling us that you filled out a bit more. You're upward of 19 stone now.
Just a little bit like that.
Is it just age? Is it a purposeful thing?
No, just naturally filled out. Like I said, give my body a bit of a rest. Been through out and back, but main thing is now is on the rise.
Well, this is what I wanted to talk about, because last time I interviewed you was during Savannah's fight week with Clarissa, and you were telling us that you were going for some treatment at Harley Street. Well, people have been concerned about you, so can you tell us how it all went and what it was?
Yeah, that was very good. Obviously, Harley Street, Dr. Khan, Paula as well, all was tremendous. They gave me golden injections, and basically, from literally not able to do anything, has put me back. It was putting me back into gear. So, literally, amazing with the gold injection. What it did from the start, 7 injections, and over the period of months, it just got better and better and better. So, that was very good.
Because you know, you thought it might have been long COVID. That you also had, you know, since you were a kid, you've had certain issues that made you a bit lethargic, skin issues, etc.
Well, listen, I've had a disaster.
Yeah.
It's not been one thing, it's been another, but that's probably for another tale, eh?
Okay. So the best thing is that you're on the mend.
On the mend, 100%. And like I say, I've just been keeping my head down here and taking it away. And believe me, I'm here now to take over all these fucking heavyweights, 100%. And me, I've been putting my head down here, but it's going to stay for long now anyway. Hopefully get these fights and get to the top.
Yeah, so you've been out a while now. You must have been itching to get in. You've had, like you said, a serious bad luck. Tell me what your mindset is like now then at the minute.
Mindset is one thing only, is getting to the top. I've been patiently, quiet, looking at all these heavyweights, but trust me, when I'm back, yeah, I'm going to storm through every single one of them, because I don't believe any of them's any good anyway. So my main thing now for me is just get back to full health, and that's what we're doing, and hopefully be back out soon.
How far away do you think you are back from full health and potentially, you know, roughly getting back fighting again?
Hopefully get some news soon. So just itching to get out there and looking forward now to press on and get to the top.
Let's talk about the, you know, just watch you there moving around. You look like, with the exercise, you look solid, but you also still got that mobility. So do you actually feel good? You know, a little bit heavier?
No, 100%. Listen, it's not like blown up like a big fat cunt. Literally, what's out of shape and all of that. It's just, I think where my body's always been training, whatever, finally give it a bit of a rest, it's just naturally filled out. I'm not one of them who eat shit. I always look after myself, maintain myself, and just is what it is.
Has the time away from boxing made you sort of like refocus and think about it? Have you missed it? Have you missed the sport?
I've never had to refocus on my mind on boxing, because I always know where my place is in boxing. Obviously, these obstacles, what I've been through, are part of life. So you just got to get on with them. God give you a test, get through with them. And now I do believe, get through the last obstacles, I'm there.
You mentioned like you've been sitting back watching the heavyweight division and you've not been too impressed. Like, is it frustrating when you see fighters getting in there and you think to yourself, oh, I could beat them?
100%. Listen, I'm not one of them, a big talker. Keep my opinions to myself, always low key. But listen, what I do see, I will let my fist do the talking. But I don't say, oh, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. I'll do it. The fact of it is now is just getting in that ring, getting the fights and getting the big fights and getting there and do it. And that's one thing I know I'm 100% confident in doing.
What are you looking forward to most then about getting back in there? What do you think? You know, in yourself and your own emotions and everything, you're looking forward to most?
Most is just get in there and enjoy it, because I love to fight. Like when we spar now, we do round in, round out, literally, and jumping in them fights. And that's what I can't wait to do, to be honest. Just get back under them lights and get them fights in.
I've noticed there as well, I've got to mention young James Dean. He's coming on so well with his career. Like, you're keeping it in the family. There's another youngster coming through. What's it like then? Because he's really, really looks up to you. You know, I was talking to him there, he looks up to you. And what's it like to have, you know, that another person in the family as well, and just to have like kind of a family feel to what you're doing here?
No, it's good. James Dean, he's a good up and comer. He's learned a lot, to be fair. He's been in the end. Dedication. It's like anything. When you're dedicated in this sport, you'll go far. And that's what I truly believe.
I've got to ask you about this. We walked in, we turned the lights on, there's this beautiful bike. It's Harley Davidson. I'm going to get some clips of it in a minute. Beautiful bike there. Tell us about this. I didn't know you was a petrolhead. I didn't know you had a bike.
Do you know what it is? I'm not one of them a speed freak or anything, but I've always wanted Harley Davidson. That's always been on my list. So I ended up, from buying one, I ended up buying two. So I'll show you in a minute my other bike.
Yeah.
That's a bit more old school, but yeah, I love the Harley Davidson bikes. And I like to cruise. I'm not one of them speed freak and all of that. Literally, in my own like enjoyment, I like to take a cruise.
You got the matching helmet, you got everything, you got all the gear.
Oh, listen, I've got the leather jacket, the helmets, you name it. I even got leather pants.
Yeah, really?
The lot.
You'll have to do your ring walk wearing the leather pants.
100%.
Where's this other bike then? Are you going to show us this other bike?
I'm going to show you it. It's not obviously not in this one, because it probably weighed the floor down, because they are way heavy. But the other one in a minute, I'll show you, is a heavy bike, but it's a Heritage.
Nice. You know what, it's great to see you back in there. And it's great to hear that you're planning the comeback in the coming months.
100%. I am looking forward to getting back and planting my name down. So that's the plan.
All right, great to see you. Thanks for your time as always.
Hey, no problem.